हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द एंगल्स एंड पेयर ऑफ एंगल्स वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द इंटीरियर एंगल्स, एक्सटीरियर एंगल्स, कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री एंगल्स, सप्लीमेंट्री एंगल्स एंड अपोजिट रे एंड लीनियर पेयर एंगल्स एंड प्रैक्टिस सेट 15, 16, 17 एंड 18 एग्जाम्पल्स. नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट. Angles and pair of angles. In first part we have to learn about the angles. Here type of angles. First we have to draw point AB. Here draw AB. Then second ray AB. Then third ray AC. And there are two rays which is common point A which is known as vertex. AC is known as arm. AB is also known as arm which is common vertex. Then this type of figure is known as angles. Here how to read angle CAB, and that is the angle is known as 44.3 degree, means major angle CAB is equal to 44.3 degree. That is the angle is known as acute angle. If you draw, then the angle is known as 90 degree angle, that is right angle. This angle is known as the right angle. Then third, if you draw this type, then known as the obtuse angle. Here there are three types: acute angle, right angle, and obtuse angle. A is known as a vertex, and AC is known as arm, and AB is also known as arm. Practice set 15. Observe the figure and complete the table. Angle AWB, here points in the interior, here first N, then X, then R and C, they are known as interior points because inside the angle AWB. Now then exterior points, here Y, then V, then Q, then U and T. These points are known as exterior of this angle AWB, means TUQV are exterior points, and then and Y, and then here on the arm G point, B point, W point and A point is lies on the arm. That means G is on the arm of WB and AB and W are the points on the arm of WA, that is W is a common point. Adjacent angles, look at the angles in the figure alongside. The here MQ is a common arm of the angle BMD and QBMD is a MQ is a common arm. M is a vertex. Here BMQ and QMD, here MQ is a common arm. They may be said to be neighboring angles. Such angles are called as adjacent angles. These angles do not have a single common point. That means here adjacent angles have one common arm and other arm is the opposite side of the common arm. That means here MQ is a one common arm of both arm is a common. Therefore, these angles are known as adjacent angles. From figure, here BMQ angle and angle QMD, they are known as adjacent angles. But here, however, BMD and BMQ, these two angles are not adjacent angles because they do not have a separate interiors. That means adjacent angles, they are separate interiors. Here this interior and this interior separate because MQ is a common arm. Therefore these two angles are known as adjacent angles, but BMD and BMQ, they are not adjacent angles because they do not have a separate interiors. Here name of the pairs of adjacent angle in the figure. Here figure is given, three rays
Here there are n is a common point. Here first pair angle A N B and angle A N C. This is the adjacent angles because A N is a common arm. Now second pair angle B N C and angle C N A. C N A. The two adjacent angles of pair. Now third, here angle B N A and angle B N C. There are three adjacent. That means pair of two adjacent angles. That means here B N is a common arm. These two angles are known as adjacent angles. A N is a common arm. These two angles are known as adjacent angles. And N C is a common arm. Therefore, these two angles are known as adjacent angles. Triangles, if the sum of the measures of two angles is a 90 degree, they are known as a complementary angles. Here first we have to draw figure. Angle PQR is a right angle, that means Q is a 90 degree. Here PQS and SQR, they are adjacent angles. Therefore angle PQS and angle SQR, they are mutually angles, that is complementary angles. Means angle PQS plus angle SQR is equal to 90 degree. Here practice set 16, write the measures of their complementary angles. Here angle 40 degree is given. It's a complementary, means 90 degree minus 40 degree, that is 50 degree, is known as a complementary angle of 40 degree. Second, 63 angle. Here complementary of 63 angle is 90 minus 63, that is 27 degree, known as complementary angle of 63 degree. Now third, 55 degree, it's a complementary angle. 90 minus 55 degree means 35 degree, known as complementary angles. And fourth, 90 degree angles, that means 90 minus 90 degree, that is 0 degree, that is known as complementary angle of 90 degree. Triangles, if the sum of the measures of two angles is 180 degree, they are known as supplementary angles. Here figure BA and BC are, they are in straight line, and BD is one arm. Here measure angle ABD and major angle DBC is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, these two angles are in supplementary angles. Means angle ABD and angle DBC are in supplementary angles. Set 17, write the measures of their supplementary angles. Here, first angle 15 degree, it's a supplementary angle. 180 minus 15 degree, that is 165 degree, is known as supplementary angle of 15 degree. Second, 85 degree, 180 minus 85 degree, that is 95 degree, is known as supplementary angle of 85 degree. Third, 120 degree, 180 degree minus 120 degree, that is 60 degree, is known as supplementary angle of 120 degree. Fourth, 108 degree means 108 degree is 180 degree minus 108 degree, that is 72 degree, is known as supplementary angle of 108 degree, means 108 degree. Now let us example second. If major angle A is equal to 70 degree, then what is the measure of the supplement of the complement of A? Means first we have to complementary angle of A and then supplementary angle. Here major angle A is 70 degree. It's a complementary angle of A, means 90 minus 70 degree, that is 20 degree, that is known as complement of A. And now it's a supplement, means supplementary angle. So supplement of the complement of A means 180 minus 20 degree, that is 160 degree, is known as supplement of the complement of angle A. Now another example, if major angle A and angle B are supplementary angles, and major angle B is equal to x plus 20 bracket degree, then what would be major of angle A? Here solution, given angle A and angle B are supplementary angles, means addition is 180 degree, means major angle A plus major angle B is equal to 180 degree. Here given major angle B x plus 20 degree, that is bracket degree, is equal to 180 degree. So plus bracket x plus 20 degree is take RHS side into bracket x plus 20 bracket degree, means major angle A is equal to 180 degree minus into bracket x plus 20 bracket degree. So here minus mean inside sign change. So major angle A is equal to 180 degree minus x minus 20 degree. 180 degree minus 20 degree, that is 160. So major angle A is equal to 160 minus x bracket degree is the answer. Here the first take the point B, then C, and if you joint ray BC, then second ray here BA, A point, and joint BA, then angle BCA. Here first point, first ray BC, then second point, second ray BA, and angle ABC here 50.6 degree. If you extend this angle like that, this type, here ray BA and BC are two opposite rays, because here major angle is 180 degree. Ray BA and ray BC are meet at point B, where B is the origin. So two rays which have a common origin and from a straight line, from a straight line, are said to be opposite ray. From figure, BA and BC are opposite ray. Set 18, name the pairs of opposite ray in the figure. Figure is given, LM is a line and NT is a line, they are intersected at point P. So pair of opposite ray, here first ray PL and ray PM, and second ray PN and ray PT are the two pairs of opposite ray. A linear pair, here figure is given, PQR and RQS, major angle PQR and major angle RQS, they are adjacent angles and also in supplementary angles. Therefore major angle PQR plus major angle RQS is equal to 180 degree. That means sum of the measures of a linear angle, sum of the measures of the angles in a linear pair is 180 degree. That means addition is 180 degree. Here two adjacent angles whose addition is 180 degree, known as the angles are known as linear pair angles. Therefore sum of the measures of the angles in a linear pair is 180 degree.